Good morning, everybody, and welcome, welcome, welcome to our Wednesday morning live painting session. Almost said coffee chat then. Hope you're all doing well. If you're joining me for the first time, my name's Rod, founder of the Learn to Paint Academy, and this is our regular Wednesday morning live stream, or Tuesday afternoon, evening, depending on whereabouts in the world you are. Good to have you all join us. Morning, Foxy in Geelong. Welcome. Morning, Sonia in Melbourne. G'day, Gary in Walla Badar. And Margaret, Victoria Point, welcome. Morning, Janet, Wayne, Fort Wayne, Indiana. And Tanya in South Florida, welcome. Nina in San Diego, welcome. G'day, Robert in Ireland, good to see you. Marge in Massachusetts, welcome. Sherry in Central Texas, welcome. Betcha, good morning in South Florida. G'day, Becky in Oklahoma, and Jenny on the Gold Coast. Welcome, welcome, welcome. And Facebook is still playing up with comments. I'm not seeing any comments at all coming through on Facebook, but if you're joining us on Facebook, welcome to you. I'll see if I can refresh. Oh, there we go. Comments aren't feeding through properly. Morning, Carlene in Sydney. Welcome. G'day, Peter in Tauranga. Welcome, that's in New Zealand. Morning, Sheena in Melbourne and Lindley in Greenvale, North Queensland. Hope you're all doing well. We're gonna have a part two of our painting session. Morning, Yvonne in WA. Morning, Linda in Moncton, Canada. Morning, Kathy. Morning, Kathy in Toowoon Bay, Australia. Morning, Sue in Canada or California? I think it's Canada. Morning. G'day, Lisa. How are you? In Mount Wallace. And Diane in Saskatchewan. Catches me every time. All right. Hope you're all doing well. And everybody else, welcome. Morning, Manju in Ontario. And Merrill over in WA there. Morning, Marie, New Hampshire. Good to see you all. Okay. Well, we're going to carry on and do our continue with our little cow. Let me see if I can bring her up. We're gonna have an utterly good time. There she is. And a few of you have already finished your cows and put it right in the members area, so well done, that was good. We're going to do a bit more work just to try and get her form right, and we'll do a little bit of a touch up in some of the foliage and the foliage. Interesting looking at it in the monitor. The foliage is quite green. It's got a green orientation, but when I look at my printout, it's quite yellow. So that tells me something about my printer. Okay, that's interesting. Well, it's interesting to me. okay. So a couple of things. We uploaded the values course yesterday. So if you're a member in the Learn to Paint Academy, the first phase, if you like, of the values course is now in the members area, which is sort of like all the preliminary background introductory type of information. And over the next 6 months, I'm going to build out more advanced training around values. It's quite an in-depth body of work, and also the color mixing course and composition. I'll be adding to these courses as we go over the next 6 months, 12 months. So, but if you are a member of the Learn to Paint Academy, then go and check out the values course and hopefully you'll find it of value. All right, it's enough of the jokes, Rod. Welcome to everybody else who's just joined us. We're about to get underway. Hey, Darlene in Alabama. And Diana in Idaho, welcome. Margarita in Coolum Beach, beautiful. Gotta love Coolum Beach. Teresa in Nova Scotia, welcome. Elvira, welcome. Okay, let us go and do a review of where we're up to here. Morning, Donna. Morning, Magdalene. Morning, Winnie. Deja Mu, says Sherry. All right. Let us go. S4, there we go. Scene number four. So, just by way of giving you an update, just before we came on live, I just tied it up around the legs because I didn't think I'd be able to do that and keep out of the way of the shot. So I've just mixed up a green and just tied it up around the legs there. And what I want to work on is just getting into this body of her here a little bit. I've also got to just bring her neck out a little bit there. So we shall do that, but of course I haven't got any brushes. 1 second, sorry about that. Where are my brushes? Bum, ba-dum, ba, da, 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 da. Okay. Sorry about walking in front of the camera there. Let's get underway here. So you can see the green I mixed up. It was a phthalo green, yellow ochre, a little bit of this cadmium yellow light type of green. So what I want to do, I'll just get into that dark tone back again, which is our blue, alizarin crimson, a little bit of this yellow ochre. Okay, we'll mix that up. And well done to you who have had a go at this one. Yeah, it's a little bit more complex with the drawing. Just getting it right is obviously important. But look, I think we've got one of the things I have to keep reminding myself is that after I finish this painting, put it in a little frame or whatever, sell it. If you're following what we're doing at the Artist Business Academy, the person who buys this and has it in a little frame at home, never going to look at the photo. So they're not going to know if you've got it slightly inaccurate or not. So as long as it looks right overall, then that's all that should matter. Okay. This brush is definitely not the best brush to do this with. See all the hairs are sprayed out. Good brush for painting trees with. I should get a more precise brush for this. So just there, it sort of bulges out. Comes up in through there. Okay. And then that neckline there's a little bit more that way. Now I've sort of, in assessing how I've gone with this, I can see that my body is too long that way, which is potentially going to cause, well, if you're comparing it to the photo, that is, it'll cause some problems. So I'm just going to create a cooler tone here. I've just added in a blue, a bit more blue, push it a bit cooler, just in there. So this is really a good way to test your observation skills. There's a lot of little nuances with this. Subject, which means you really have to observe carefully. And that's a good thing. We need to train ourselves on. I believe. I've gone and made that leg a little bit too crooked. There we go, it's a bit better. And. So this is really getting down into details where, you know, I'd slow down and typically do a lot less talking. Just to concentrate. And I think it's a challenge just having a dark that's all one tone. That's why I put a little bit of cooler tone in there. But I'm going to put a little bit more red into part of the parts that are going to be catching a bit more light. Okay. It just builds her out a little bit more. So I'm going to keep one brush with my darks and my one for the oranges and one for the foliage colours. Which makes sense, doesn't it? Just when I make any little slip-ups like that, I can just touch them up. Okay, now the tail is, it's mostly that orange colour, but I'll just run it down with a bit of a shadow there. And if that's a bit long, this is why I want to keep my green brush handy. I can just tidy that up. Haven't decided about that little cow in the background yet. Okay, so now I think we need to mix up that orange tone. And I really need to get that brighter and warmer. So we can start getting a bit more of a highlight feel. So that's too red. So think about what we did last week is the blocking, and blocking and middle values. Now I want to get some warmer, lighter values in there. Okay. As soon as I have white, I'm just going to just make it go a bit murky. Not murky, a bit sort of pale and pasty. So come back in with a bit of that yellow ochre, and possibly a bit more of the... Let's test something like that. Oop, that's a vastly different tone, isn't it? Will that convey a sense of sunlight? Or is it too light? Perhaps too light. Let's just bring it back a little bit. Get a little bit more yellow into that mix. I'll try and keep that tone we put on the other day, but I think that's, I just need to darken that just slightly. It's too light of value, I think. Potentially work. I'm not going to erase it just yet. Oh, even my little brush has got funky hairs. Okay, I'm going to get rid of that cow in the back. I've been tossing up what to do, but just for simplicity's sake, we'll just erase her out there. Actually, just a little hint of her in amongst the foliage would work, I think. What do you think? I think that area of dark needs to be bigger. I'm just going to be careful I don't get too carried away with it. But feels a bit better, a bit more balanced. And I'll come up with this dark tone and I'll just work some of that in here. And I'll connect those. And you've got that darker orangey tone just there. Okay, pause there for a moment, just have a sip of my cuppa and see how you're all going. If you have any questions, then fire away. How are we all doing here? How are we all doing? Becky says the cow, second cow is in an awkward position. I think you're right, but I kind of like the way it's peeking through there, just a little hint of it. So, yeah, I agree with you, Manju. Since I reduced it in size, I think that's going to work better. Quite the cow medians. Oh, good to see everyone's brought their cow jokes. Why can't cows wear shoes? Because they lack toes. So nobody's been paying attention to me painting at all. You've just all been having your own thing going on. Fair enough. Tanya says she started the values course today and it's very helpful. Good on you, Tanya. Where are we up to here on Facebook? Facebook, why did you change? Never ending change, I guess. Whoop. So far away if you've got any questions. I'm just taking a little break. Peter says you started watching the new values course last evening. Great to revisit the basics. Good on you, Peter. Morning, Terry Ann. Morning, Steve. Morning, Jenny. Morning, Rosalie. Morning, Barbara in Brisbane. Morning, Mary in Ireland. Welcome. G'day, Pauline in Wales. And Beverly in Ontario. Welcome. Diana says the cow is shaping up. Good colour, I like. Good on you, Diane. Yeah, it's just a matter of just now we're at that point now, we're just going to massage it back and forward until we get it, you know, to a pleasing overall look and feel. And, you know, keeping in mind, I deliberately picked a photo where there was very strong darks and very strong lights on it. So there's not a lot of sort of nuances besides those two areas. Okay. Kathy said, you make things look so easy. Not easy, I'm sweating on this one. Diana says, yes, good idea hiding the cow in the foliage. Colin says, good solution. Yes, so I think we've got a bit of a consensus on that. At least everyone loves a good cow joke, except for the cows. Cindy says, this painting is wonderful. Yeah, it's stretching it, I think. It's stretching it. All right. Seems like there's no questions. So, you know what that means. We shall get back into it. How are we going? Okay, got a bit of time. Okay, so because I've just worked on the cow, strengthening some darks, adding in some, you know, more of the highlight tones, what I think we need to do now is move away from the cow and bring up the grasses and the foliage areas just a little bit more, rather than, you know, things getting too out of balance, which they're starting to kind of feel at the moment like they potentially will. Dawn loves to move the paint around. Move the paint around. I'll take the bull by the horns and move on to WA. Okay, good-o. I suppose I did encourage you all last week, didn't I? Okay. I'm just going to put a little bit more punch in the colour in the back, but first I might just, let's just play around with that cow rather than just talking about it. Let's just pop a few indications of colour. So we've got some shadow tone in through there. Okay, there's a little bit there. And we'll get into maybe a slightly lighter tone because she's just a touch further away. Okay, so it's not going to be like the photo because I'm going to hide most of her. Something like that. Just a little hint of her. It is an unfortunate position. So this is a design issue, really, isn't it? You know, when we talk about the Moore method of painting, we're talking about getting our composition or our design right, and that's big shapes. Where are we putting those big shapes? Get them in the right spot on the canvas, in the right shape. Okay, so perhaps we didn't pay enough attention to that secondary cow there. In our rush to paint our main cow. Now, I did say I was going to move on to the foliage, so what on earth am I doing at the moment? Just wanted to get a little bit more interest in there. OK. Somebody tell me to stop playing with cows. And get my background foliage painting brush out. Okay, just realised, sorry, that I'm on the wrong screen. There we go. I need a producer, director for our live streams. Okay, so there's a little bit more punch in the foliage I just wanted to bring in. Through there, a little bit more in there. Trying not to clip into my cow, because that'll be a bit of a cow of a thing to do. And the question is, how much background do we need to really do here? Not a lot, I don't think. If you detail up the background too much, then you're competing with your main subject. And that just won't work out well. Just got a dark green here just to fill in a couple of spots. If I push those darks a little bit more, then guess what's going to happen with that foliage I just painted in? It'll just pop out a little bit more. Careful, Rod. Okay, let's get just break up this green a little. Strengthening this dark in here, it's giving the painting a little bit more depth. Can you see that, or is it just me? Sometimes I wonder whether things translate well on the video with the lighting and things in here, but to me it's looking like there's a lot more depth into that background, and our old girl is starting to pop out a little bit more as a result. Can you guys see that? Might just do a little bit of palette knife in there as well, just for, it's always, I find it tricky with grass. I don't like painting blades of grass. I don't like that kind of detail where you're just really finicky And I know there are realist artists around who do that well, but that's just not me, right? So how do I make this sort of grassy area look interesting without actually trying to paint grass, you know, getting too carried away with trying to make it look like grass? I'm more into how do I just get a feel of a field, right, with different types of grasses and so on. So sometimes a palette knife is quite a handy tool for that. It just adds a little bit of hit and miss, and it creates layers, effect, and a bit of texture. But I wouldn't want that same sort of texture happening in the back here. That's why I'm using a brush and I'm sort of softening it in, pushing it back into the darks, and so on. Okay. I'm even putting a few scratch marks into the foreground there. Now we do have a little fence post, which I'll, we'll just work on those a little. Some of this background foliage, I can just soften it in with the knife. As I said, the texture in the front and on the cow. It's got to be sort of a little bit blurred off, defocused a little. So we've got those little fence posts. Same dark as I'm using in the cow. How good is that? Saves me having to mix up another dark. Oh, Bessie's already got a dark. So, we'll just run with that. And if we're going to use the same dark, then guess what we're going to do with the highlight? We're going to use the same one, right? Now, I saw a couple of you, you'd done a big fence across the front, and maybe it was just one person, I don't know, but just think about how the eye moves into a painting, right? If you put that fence post too dominant across the front, it kind of blocks your view, the way the eye is going to move into that painting. So just be mindful of that. Trying to make it look a bit rustic. Okay, so the highlight tone we're going to use is going to be the same as what we've got on the cow. Let's go with the brighter tone. Am I blocking? No, there we go. And I wasn't criticizing, I was just, it was an observation that I think will improve your painting. Okay. Now I've got this brush, I can just soften in a few little spots in here. This section there just doesn't quite feel right, but it's almost there. Okay, so I need to pop some couple little dark marks back into over here. And this is the refining and finessing, isn't it? This is where we really have to concentrate. And really look closely at what's going on. One thing I've just noticed is that I haven't got an udder in light there. Which you won't be happy about. And there's a little bit of a rim highlight along here. I don't know why, it's the fold of the skin there. That goes into there. And then there's a bit that, I haven't got the overall shape of it right, but there's a little bit that just comes in there, like so. Come back into the dark and, this whole area here needs to just find where the darks are. So there's a little dark fold there, push it up into a dark just in there, runs that dark just over there a little. I'm just going to work on something in there to make that just work a little bit better, and I suspect I need to get a cooler, almost pure ultramarine blue in there. And then I'll take more of the alizarin crimson and I'll just work that down into her face a little bit more along the back there. All right, now I'm just going to experiment and get a little bit more of a yellow, which will give me a warmer tone. Probably not that big of a jump. Let me try again. Yeah, don't want to push it too much. Right. still think that dark there is. So some shape issues, but it's, as I said, nobody's going to look at it and compare it to the photo when they have it at home. And this is a very saleable little painting, because people love paintings of cows. Anything to do with farm life, actually. I don't know if it's because of a bit of a romantic notion that people have about farm life. Possibly it is, but people love farm type paintings. Cows and chooks always seem to be popular. All right, friends, I don't know that I'm going to do much more than this. I think it's got to where it needs to be for a bit of an instructional sort of painting. If you have questions, and start typing them in. Move that a little bit more foliage at the back. A good fun little painting, hey? Most important thing is that she looks like an old cow or a young cow. Who would know? I'll post up a photo of the close-up of the, just so you can see some of the shifts in the temperature and tones and so on in this one, because I don't know that it's translating on the video, but I'm going to stop right there. See what questions or comments you all have. And so if you have a question, feel free to start typing it in now. A few people asked me about signing their paintings. I can't remember if it was on our live stream last week or was somewhere. So basically I use a red paint like this. Okay, use my rigger brush, Keep the paint fairly loose so it's a little bit fluid, kind of like an ink-like consistency. And then I just clean off my brush and then just drag the tip through. And the thing about the signature is you don't want a fancy signature, you want a signature people can read. And also remember, if you're gonna put it in a frame, you have to bring it in a little bit. Don't put it right up against the edge, right? So you want a signature that people can read and go, oh yeah, that's right, that was that Rod Moore guy. If your signature's unreadable, in 2 years' time, after they've bought your painting, and they can't remember who you are, your name, and then their friends come over and go, oh my God, I love that cow painting. Where'd you get that? And they go, oh, let's have a look at what the artist's name is. But they can't read your signature because you've done some fancy signature because you think it has to be a signature. Then guess what? You've forgotten to history. However, if you do a little signature that stands out, is easy to read, and simple sort of simple little letters like that, anyone can read that. Moore. And then they go, oh, Moore, yeah, what was his first name? Yeah, let's look him up. And then the friend who's come over for a dinner party, not thinking she wanted a cow painting, now has a really strong desire for a cow painting. And so next thing you know, they're on the internet looking up, while they're having their cocktails, looking up Rod Moore, the artist, right? And buying another one. Just realized there's a little bit of light on that leg that we haven't got yet. So keep your signature simple. A little bit of light just there. And there. See that little patch of light on that front hoof there? I know I was about to finish, however, when things sort of jump out at you, I'll just get some warmer tone. Pushing those highlights just a little bit more. That'll just show the sun effect. Okay, now I'm gonna stop.
Okay.
Now I'm going to stop. There we go, folks. Old Bessie in the field. What size rigger do I use? As I said last time, I don't really like giving out sizes because it's going to vary from manufacturer to manufacturer. This is a Rosemary & Company number 4 Evergreen rigger. And it is that size. Probably a medium size is what I'd call it, because every manufacturer has a different numbering system. There's no standards with the numbering, okay? So it's a medium size rigger. So you want a fat rigger, you want a ultra thin rigger, and you want a medium one, I think. So, alrighty, let's just see if there's any other questions. Cows become the flavour of the month. How do you colour the legs to give the impression of front and back when they are so close? Because they're so close, Sherry, I've just done them in the same dark. I haven't tried to distinguish them. Pardon me. So it's really just the shape and angle of them, I think, is what's going to separate them front to back. Peter said, big takeaway for me in the treatment of the foliage. Let's just go and grab this. If you have a look at the photo there, you can see that foliage is quite distinguished, isn't it? Like it's standing out a lot more than the way I painted it. So we have to make decisions as artists as to how much attention we focus in on each area, right? So I've deliberately downplayed the foliage on it. Make our cow stand out more. Photo doesn't know to do that, right? The photo doesn't know that we're going to turn it into a painting, so it won't do that. So that's a good takeaway, Peter. Meryl says, looks great. I'm just wanting to put a slight curve under her jaw. Yep, good-o. Do that one. I hope to replay the live streams to refer to later today. Cool. After a few paint on cow, looks very good. Thanks, Winnie. So Joe says, Rod, just want to confirm that you started green with phthalo green and then added yellows. Yes, pretty much. Yeah, that's what I've done. I use a little bit of phthalo green just to speed things up. Sharon says, yes, the background looks really out of focus, so the main event is popping. Good, good. Alrighty. Any other questions over on Facebook? What questions do we have? Now, if anybody wants to buy this one, then as we've been doing, selling the demo paintings, so just contact our support desk. Good one, Teresa. Why did the cow cross the road? Because he got a move on order. too many. Good cow. I do struggle with cows, so it helped heaps. Good on you, Rosalie. Glad it helped. I think, you know, cows are difficult because there's so many elements to their body. You just got to really dig in. Now, I've got my body too long, which means that this area in here and this area in here, it's just not quite right. Should be a little bit more compressed, but not to worry. Sandra says, when you say to notice the temperature shifts, you're talking about colour changes. Well, Sandra, colour has a temperature. If you look at the colour wheel, we've got warm side, we've got a cool side. And the colour, I mean, you can't really distinguish in there. It's all a dark, right? It's difficult to distinguish, but there's a cool dark and there's a warm dark. And this is why I recommend not to use black, because you'll only end up with one flat colour. But when you put temperature in there, a warmer version of the same colour or a cooler version, then you are going to end up with subtle shifts and things that sort of vibrate together. So that's what we mean. Our colour mixing course probably be a good one to go through and understand about colour temperature. Pauline says, this would look great on the wall of the Moody Cow Barn restaurant in West Wales. It's full of cow paintings. Well, there you go. Let them know, Pauline. just contact our support desk if anyone's interested in buying old Bessie here. Nana said, good morning, Rod. Question about MDF boards. My hardware store doesn't do cutting service. I live in Perth. Just wondering where I could go. I used to get them done at Bunnings, Nana Marge. And then when I got sick of Bunnings, my local Bunnings anyway, I Googled MDF board manufacturer and cutting service, and I found a local business that did them. Often like cabinet makers, kitchen cabinetry makers, they will do them. So you just have to hunt around. You can buy them, I think, on Amazon pre-done and everything, but they'll cost you a lot more. Okay. Over on the other Facebook page, Colin says, looks great, Rod, very rural. When's milking time? Milking time will be right after, after I finish up here. And I've got another appointment to go to after this. Morning, April. April said, I can't see clearly on my tiny screen, so forgive me if I'm wrong, but do you think her tail needs a little bit of shadow? There's no shadow showing in the photo, but yeah, possibly. Maybe a touch of dark. I started with dark on her tail, but perhaps lost it. But if you mean under her tail on the ground, that's not showing in the photo. So up to you, put it in if you want. Teresa said, it's lovely. Taking the background cow and making it smaller definitely adds depth and brings focus to old Bessie. Yes, absolutely. It was too big originally, wasn't it? Love the background trees and fence. I look forward to finishing mine off. It was a challenge for me to get the first stage done, but I welcome that awesome project. Good on you, trees. Just keep battling away with it, and it'll start to fall into place soon enough. Morning, Julie and Markula. Mooching about with cows. Good on you, Julie. Which cows are you mooching about with today? G'day, Linda. Linda says, love how those little touches of highlights in the fence bring the cow forward and the foliage move back. Yeah, terrific. Good observation, Linda. Colin says, those trees popped out really well, like your grass is using a palette knife. Hello in Provence. G'day, Anne. How are you? Hope you're doing well. Morning, Julie. All right. Where are we up to? Manju says, the painting is more striking than the reference photo and the background foliage looks very mysterious. A lot of depth. Yeah, good observation, Manju. All right, friends. Her eye is, I've just put a tiny little dot there, but it's just, you'd have to look closely at the photo. It's definitely a little indication of it there. I don't know if I've got it quite in the right spot, and I've made it jump out a little bit too much, so I'll just soften that back in. Ah, stop fiddling, Rod. So that's roughly where her eye is. All right, friends. My pleasure, Magdalene. Thanks for joining us. Thanks, Winnie. We're going to wrap it up. Wrap it up. I'll take it. Wrap it up. Friends, thank you so much for joining me. We won't be doing an advanced live stream tomorrow, unfortunately. But Friday, we're back with our coffee chat. So look out for that. As I said earlier, the values course, phase one of the values course, is now in the members area. So go and check that out. And there's a fair bit more to come on that. There's my alarm telling me I have to get going to my next appointment. So we'll wrap it up there. Thank you all so much for joining me. And thank you all very much for your cow jokes. I'll talk to you all soon. Well, Friday. I'll talk to you all Friday. And a lot going on behind the scenes at the moment. Working on module 2 of the Artist Business Academy. So hoping to get some of that out for you later this week. Start getting first parts of module 2 out. And then, you know, more of module 2 will follow the week after and the week after that. So over the next couple of weeks, we'll get module 2. And module 2 is all about marketplace, you know, starting to make your paintings available in the marketplace. So that's where the rubber hits the road, isn't it? We start to actually put ourselves out there into the great wide world of art, selling and buying. Alrighty, so look out for that. And see you Friday for our coffee chat. Oh, hang on. Diane says, can we still get into the ABA for the one-time low price, and does that give us full membership? Okay, good question. So just quickly, the price that we offered the ABA during the Unleash the Artist Challenge was $397 US. That price is no longer available. So the current price for those who join as an early bird is $497 US, okay? And that price will keep going up over the next 3 months. It will be, the entry sort of basic membership level will be $997 US by the end of this year. And that'll give you full access to all the courses. There will be some higher levels, which I've already had one person join on one of the higher levels, which is where I work with you one-on-one. Obviously, I can only do that in a limited capacity. So the current price is $497. If you want to come and join us in the ABA, for that $497 US, contact our support desk and they'll give you the link. And yeah, you can still join. I'm not going to promote it too much more in the next few months. We might do, actually, I might do in July, August, a little 3-day mini challenge like we did with Unleash, but for the business side of things. And we might promote it during that, and that'll be it until, you know, we officially launch. And when we officially launch later this year, it'll be $997 will be the entry price, which will be incredibly good value, because if you follow just the first little course we're working on right now, for 2 months, you know, you do it successfully for 2 months, it's 100% paid for itself, and then you're going to get access to all the other courses I build that are included in the basic membership for nothing. So it's going to be incredibly good value, even at $997. So if you're all interested in selling your artwork in any capacity or building an income around your artwork, okay, so I've been able to build an income stream around, I've got multiple income streams around the central thing, which is my art, right? So teaching's one of it, selling, there's a number of other things that I do to generate income. If any of that interests you at any point in the future, then join today. Don't delay, right? Even if you're not quite ready to start selling, you may as well join today and save $500, okay? Rather than join in 4 months' time, 5 months' time, when it will be at the full price. And yes, it'll give you life membership. So it's going to be a one-off fee to join. Okay, so contact support if that's of interest to you. Otherwise, I have to go. I've got an appointment to go to. I've already said that. Enjoy your day. And.